Workers in this factory are rushing to meet deadlines for orders set by big retailers operating in the Philippines. But the owner of this factory explains they may be busy, but it doesn't mean they're making a lot of money. He says they are actually taking the blow as they could not raise prices of their products to cope up with rising prices of materials.
We have no control over it kasi taxes, importation costs, tumataas po talaga. So, absorb na lang namin. Hanggang hindi na namin kayang i-absorb, then we have to increase the price. Kaya lang may epekto po talaga yan sa sales.
The textile industry is not similar to other businesses like food production, wherein people would still buy their products despite the rising costs. A good example would be the workers of this factory. Evelyn Nebres has been working here for 8 years, but she will not prioritize buying a bag she has to work on over her budget for transport and food.
Pag nag-grocery ka, siyempre medyo ramdam mo kasi yung budget mo na 1,000, medyo kumonti yung nabibili mo.
There's no word of a wage increase, but Senate President Vicente Soto III proposed the legislation of a 14th-month pay for workers. It's good for workers and not bad either for businesses if business is really doing good. But is it doable with the current rate of inflation?
Saan po kukuha ng karagdagang negosyo? Kasi lahat po pataas eh. Kagaya ng sinasabi ko, ina-absorb lang namin yung inflation eh.
It seems inflation has not only affected ordinary workers, but also entrepreneurs and businesses in the country. George Carino, ABS-CBN News.